Hello everyone. In this video, you'll learn about the basics of MAC repertory. So, MAC repertory, it's the most flexible tool for a homeopath. It's very versatile, very fast. You can customize it the way you want and much more. So there is some lot of interesting learning every time when you use the programs. What is it that you will see in this video? It's about how to open the basic repertory and the different repertories. How you select rubrics, open and close the remedies. How do you perform some quick searches? Suppose you don't know some rubrics and you would like to perform some quick searches. And some drag and drop options which can really help you. And the repertorization graphs. And how you can go to ReferenceWorks, which is a sister program and can help you a lot, and much more. So let's go over MAC repertory and learn how to open the basic repertory and the different repertories. So when you open the program, you can see in the left hand side corner, this is called as a tool palette, and there is a repertory book over here. And there are few clipboards A, B, C, D, and this 1 to 6. So in all there are 10 clipboards. These are the clipboards where you will park your rubrics. Here is the patient chart and the repertorization graph, which opens up from this MAC repertory repertorization graph, and some expert systems for you. A lot of expert systems, I can tell you hundreds and many. And you can create your own also. And then there is a plus and minus sign, which is the elimination tool. And here is the keynote part, which helps you read the keynotes. So let's go over and open the repertory. So I just click over here in this repertory part, repertory icon, and it opens up my basic repertory, which is complete 2015. Now if I would like to shuffle to other repertories, I just go over here and I can see all these different repertories in my program, which is starting from A, say acute, LN, Bachkind, Boninghausen, Boric, Boger, Clark, Easyaga, and lot many repertories. Each repertory has its own use. We can learn in the further videos about how each repertory can help you. Now about this program and how you can use it. So there are some interesting things about this program. So you go to the particular chapter, say mine, and you just click over it. So there are a few rubrics which open up. Now in some of the cases the rubrics are already open, you can see the remedies. So you can go to the options where you can select no remedies, and if you would like to see or hide the sub rubrics, you can do so. And there are author abbreviations under each remedy you would like to see. You just click author abbreviations so you can verify the source from which this remedy came, and the remedy count in the rubric, as well as the cross references. Now you would like to go to a particular rubric, for example dreams of snakes. So you just type over your dream and the program directly leaps over to the rubric dreams. You can see the words appear and disappear over here in the bottom. You need not go to a particular window and type the word, but just do a random typing when this window is the most dominant, and your program will leap over to that rubric. Let me perform this once again. So you are in this program where you have opened up your repertory. You go to the mind section, and now I would like you to see over here how the words appear, and suddenly your program leaps over to that rubric. So it goes to dreams, and then you can either do a setting in the program from the options under preferences to double click and open the rubric, or else you can just type the right arrow on your keyboard to go inside the rubric and the left arrow to come outside the rubric. So I want to go inside the rubric, I just type the right arrow, and now I would like to take the rubric Dreams of Snakes. So I go over and take the rubric Dreams of Snake. There are two ways in which I can take this rubric. I can drag it to the clipboard, or I can just press and enter, and you can see next to the alphabet B in the clipboard there are two lines which have come up. So this is where my rubric has been parked. Now I would like to take another rubric, which is Fear of Snakes. So I just go one step back by clicking on the word Dreams, and I come back, and now I just type Fear, and then I press the right arrow on my keyboard and it goes inside the rubric, and then I press Fear Snakes Off. I just press enter and take this rubric also. Now suppose I would like to combine this rubric, so I just go to the clipboard and I select both the rubrics, and now I go to my keyboard and I press the button plus. Now it shows me to enter a name for this merged rubric. I just go over to this window where I have to enter a name, and I can just write snake, just whatever name I can think of at this moment, and it combines both the rubrics together and gives me a combined rubric which has 111 remedies. Now suppose there is another symptom in this case, another rubric I would like to take, which is pain in the ear. So I go to the ear section and I don't know where the rubric is. Suppose I don't know the rubric, so I can do a quick search over here. I just go to the bottom window in this search window and I just type pain. Now it has searched for all the pains everywhere in the ears chapter. I press spacebar to just give a space, and I press ear. Now I would like to take only the rubrics. I would like to see only the rubrics where the pain and ear is there. So there is a option just in front of the letters I just entered, and I click over here and I see that I need to match all the words. It has to be anywhere in the rubric, and I want to see only the matching rubrics. So just if I do this, I have lot of rubrics which have these two words, which is pain and the ear. And suppose I would like to take any rubric. It can be pain in the ear general, or it can be pain extending to ear to ear, and I just press enter and it gets recorded in the rubric, in the clipboard, rubric clipboard. Now the main thing I have to do when I exit this chapter is to remove this ball, is to click over this ball. This is because I have created a temporary limit in this particular window to select my choice of rubrics, to search and select my choice of rubrics. So I just click over here and it turns into green. So it means that I have removed my words, and now I can just press the left arrow to come out, and I come to the main page of the repertory. And now I can go to the other chapters. Say for example, I would like to go to generalities and search for the rubric food and drinks, and I just click food and drinks, and I do a right arrow to go inside the rubric sweets, and then sweets desire, and I take the rubric sweets desire. Now this is my totality, which you can see. So I would like to see the graph of this patient, and I just click over here in this graph over here, and I can see that there are some remedies coming up: Hepar, Thuja, Argentum Nitricum, Kalikap, Arsenic, Sulfur, and I have my combined rubric also in the same place, as well as the primary symptom of the case and the desire of sweets. So I would like to study the graph now. Now suppose suddenly in my mind I have a thought of seeing this particular rubric, ears pain extending ear to ear, and I would like to see its occurrence in the repertory. How many other remedies are covering? So I have the option to drag and drop this rubric to my repertory window. Let me do it in this case. So I just select this rubric from my repertory graph, from my remedy graph, and drag it to the repertory clipboard. And once I click over here, it directly opens up exactly in the same place where the rubric is placed in the repertory. Now, since I have kept the option no remedies, I would not be able to see the remedies now. But if my rubric is selected and I press the space bar, I can see the remedies. There are a lot of remedies, 19 remedies, Belladonna, Palladium, Hepa, and all the other remedies. I leave the space bar and my remedies are hidden. So this helps me to every time take an unprejudiced selection of the rubrics. Very interesting. So let's go back to the repertoriation graph. And over here, when I see the repertoriation graph, there are some remedies coming. And if I would like to see the other remedies, I just scroll with my right arrow to go to the right side and come back to the left arrow and come to the left hand side corner. And in this way, I can go over to the different remedies in this remedy graph. If I would like to read the materia medica of these remedies, I just drag this remedy to the keynotes, the key over here in the tool palette, and it opens up exactly in the place where my Borix materia medica explains about Hepar. Now it's very interesting about here, about the materia medica in MAC repertory. It's the way you can read the remedies, the way they are present in the graph. For example, let me drag this window to the left, and you can see in the graph there is a mention of Hepar, then Thuja, then Argentum nitricum, then Kali Carb, then arsenic. And in the Borix materia medica in the keynotes, you can see it's mentioned about Hepar, and then there is a window, a point in the left hand side corner where you can just click and change to the next remedy, and you click and it opens up Thuja, and you click and it opens up Argentum nitricum, and you further click and it opens up Kali Carb. So you are changing the next remedy but in the same book, which is Borix materia medica. And if you would like to read Kali Carb from the different books which you are having in your MAC repertory materia medica library, you just click over this graph icon, which will switch to the books part, and now you can read Kali Carb onicum from Boger synoptic key, from Bradford's index, from Breakfoil's epitoem, and so on and so forth. So I'll close this window. Now we would like to save this case. So there are a few options in which we can save the case. One is by going to file and save patient's chart as. So I go to this save patient's chart as, and I just type any name. And once I click save, it gets saved over here. So you go to the left hand side corner of this patient's chart, and you can see it has a mention about the different patient information, analysis and diagnosis, which you can definitely fill up. There are a lot of things to fill up over here, and you can save it by Control plus S, which is the save option. And then there is analysis and diagnosis, which you can put and again save it. And then plan and prescription, whatever plan and prescription you are having. You would like to save the clipboard as well as the graph. So you have to do it individually, because there are a lot of searches we do perform in our study of every particular case. So you would like to save this particular graph, and you press Control plus S, and you go to the clipboard and you press Control plus S, which saves your graph. And here you have the whole patient information along with the graphs over here. And if you would like to enter some notes about this patient, about during the case taking, that he has fear of snakes and dreams of snakes, and so on and so forth, that he has sweets desire. So you can just go on typing over here. You can mention the remedy, you can mention his investigations over here, and you can go on adding whatever you feel like, and press Ctrl plus S to save the notes also. Now you have combined a few rubrics in your clipboard. You'd like to remove the combined rubric and see it individually. So you go to the clipboard over here. Let me close the other windows. You go to the clipboard over here, you select the combined rubric and enter and press the backspace, which will remove the rubric, and you have two rubrics which are striked out: dreams of snakes and fear of snakes. So you just press 0 and it opens up both the rubrics. It does not combine, it opens up individually. And now if you see the graph, you can see the change in the repertorization, which shows Thuja as the first remedy, Argentum Nitricum, Hepar. And now if you would like to save this second graph also, you can do so. You press Ctrl plus S and it goes and saves the same graph also again. So you can save innumerable graphs for any particular patient. Now over here, you would like to read this remedy from reference works, which has a huge library. So you go to this remedy and you click over here, view remedy in reference works. And once you do that, the reference works has opened up Thuja directly in the books where it has a mention, say Ellen's Encyclopedia, and you open the generalities section and you scroll down to read the remedy entirely. Or you want to read some other section, you just click on generalities over here and you come back and you go to ICE, and then you can read further ICE, and so on and so forth. And suppose you now go back to your Mac repository. So this is how it can help you. Right. So lot of things we learned about the drag and drop rubrics also, and see the repertorization graphs, and also going to reference works. There is a lot much more about this program. We'll keep you updated. Stay tuned to Synergy to help you discover more about these programs and help you grow in your practice. So we would like to say that these tools are a lot of inspiration for all of you, and we homeopaths are always there to guide you in your practice and your prescription. That's all at this moment from the Synergy team. Thank you.